This is a glowing piece of potato peeler. But why a potato peeler? And how did we get here? Keep watching to find out.
It's pretty easy to forget with today's modern LED light globes that incandescents were even once a thing for household lighting. But there was a time when they made up pretty much all of that market, and even the halogen globe. It was a significant jump in efficiency from what came before it. But there's actually another kind of incandescent lamp, a whole lot more obscure. It was invented in the late 1800s by Walther Nernst, and, unsurprisingly, it's called the Nernst lamp. So as you can see, that didn't even get hot enough to give us a decent looking glow, and the wire oxidized and it burnt out. So the way traditional light bulbs deal with this is that they put the filament in an inert gas atmosphere where it can't oxidize and burn out. But what if there was another way to deal with the problem? What if we made the filament out of something which didn't oxidize, say ceramic? But hang on, it doesn't conduct electricity. Ah, but quick and the simple of it is that materials which are insulators can't have the electrons knocked loose just by a bit of electric charge to pass on to the next atom to form a wave of electrons traveling down the material in order to conduct electricity. But it's close to being able to do this, just not quite. What if we just got the atoms to be a bit more active? What if we got them to move around a little more? And we can do this quite simply by heating it. So all we've got to do is get our hands on some zirconium oxide ceramic and heat it up a bit, and we should find that it in fact conducts electricity. Where would we get zirconium oxide ceramic from? One item which makes use of zirconium oxide ceramic is ceramic kitchen knives. These two were made by Kyocera, and if you think that's a little weird that Kyocera makes kitchen knives when you think of them more for consumer electronics, actually you mean this thing. Arguably the world's first laptop computer. Well then, you'd be kinda wrong, because Kyocera is short for the Kyoto Ceramics Company. They actually make a lot of ceramics products. So, have here some ceramic potato peelers. Hopefully these are the right kind of ceramic. And so we're gonna cut that up and wedge it in place. Yep, there we go. 12 mil. Okay, well, I sure hope this goes well.
I think we were still losing too much heat to the edges. We confirmed it was still open circuit with the multimeter. The design was changed to use longer bolts and not have the ceramic touching the metal T-slot directly. The longer bolts didn't help though, and all we did was set the insulation on fire. Was this even the right material? Maybe we should try the real thing.
Do I sacrifice it for the cause?
Well, that's the expensive one. This had better work.
Nope, cracked it again. So, got another idea.
Uneven heating is causing the blades to crack in half, but using copper wire to attach it may reduce the heat loss. Multimeter testing is showing that the resistance is starting to drop. It's promising, but I think we need less wire.
Oh, I should probably turn that off. Oh, current draw's going up. Oh. Oh, there we go. Had something for a moment there. So that's hitting 1 amp. Yep, crank her up. Yep. Seven, eight. Oh.
This was a better attempt, but I think 8 amps might have been a bit too much to push through it.
18, 20, 27. There we go.
Boom! It seems the problem that we have here is that when the ceramic gets to a temperature at which it glows brightly enough, it's vaporizing the copper which arc flashes over between the terminals. We tried some alligator clips instead, but they just didn't make proper contact.
So you reckon at some point the copper
bridged over, essentially.
It's about 2 already. Yep.
So at this point, provided you didn't try and make it run any brighter, it was actually pretty stable.
20 watts. Did you want to try and crank it up?
Let's crank it up to 7.
What's that?
It's 33 watts.
Like, I think the copper's starting to burn.
I mean, that's not what you call dim, but for... Ooh.
Yeah, it's still going.
And then now we're putting... yeah.
Is that just copper at this point, or...?
No. And yeah, dropping 10 amps into it at like 3 volts.
We gave the alligator clips another go, but this time with car battery clamps. But would they sink too much heat out of it? The answer, it appears to be, is yes. So it's back to the copper wire again, but this time we're trying to get more of the blade lit up. Less spectacular this time, the copper wire just melted and it went open circuit.
Not quite. There we go. That's all the 3 amps.
Yeah, crank it up.
What do you want it at?
8.
No, I can just like sit it like there. And 6.
6, yeah. Well, that's a bigger area. Oh.
The copper burned out, didn't it? Yeah, that's an open circuit again.
So at this point we had it working fairly reliably, until you increased the power too far and the copper failed. I decided to try some galvanized fencing wire to see how that would go. The answer being, not well. Too much heat loss. Back to the copper, I guess. So we've shown the concept works, and the ceramic in both cheap and expensive potato peelers is the right stuff. I'd like to try with some different material for the wires, maybe some tungsten for the higher melting point.
Like, it's a piece of glowing potato peeler. It's glowing, it's not burning out. It's a light bulb to me.